with city vaccine mandates. I'm wondering where you stand on that. Should police officers, emergency responders be mandated to get vaccines? And if not, should they be stay at home or let go?
Yes and yes. By the way, I waited until July to talk about mandating because I tried everything else possible. The mandates are working. All the stuff about people leaving and people getting, you have everyone from United Airlines to Spirit, all these airlines, we're not going to get all 96-97% of the people have gotten the vaccine. All the talk about all these folks who are going to leave the military if they're mandated, not true. You got about a 90-some percent vaccination rate. I mean, so there's the idea is that, look, the two things that concern me. One are those who just try to make this a political issue. Freedom. I have the freedom to kill you with my COVID. No, I mean, come on. Freedom.
I have the freedom to kill you with my COVID. Oh, come on, man. People who are vaccinated can still give it. We are learning. Joe Biden said police, emergency responders should be fired if they won't get vaccinated. This former ESPN reporter, interviewed by Megyn Kelly, referred to Joe Biden as a dictator.
What did you make of that when Joe Biden issued his statement saying, we've been patient, but our patience is running thin?
I have never been so jarred by anything a president said, and I know Trump said some really crazy things, but to hear the leader of the free world stand up and say, this isn't about your freedom. I thought, oh my God, it is always about our freedom. This country exists on the principle of freedom. We are the land of the free and the home of the brave. And if we don't have freedom over our own bodies, if our bodily autonomy is not respected, this God-given, constitutionally protected right to determine what we do with our bodies, we aren't free. That was scary to me, honestly, Megan. That was something a dictator says. That is not something a leader of free people says. What happened to the consent of the governed? What happened to the power of the people? Those are the two things that keep standing out to me when I analyze this debate or when I have this discussion with people. It's two things. It's freedom and it's consent. And you can't have one without the other. And I'm talking about true consent. Everybody acts like, okay, well, this was your choice. You chose not to get it, so go get a different job. That's not choice. That's coercion. Mm-hmm. Okay? Consent is fundamental to everything we do if we want to be a free people. Consent is the difference between two of the same acts and one becomes a crime without consent. And true consent, not pressure, not bullying, not you're going to lose your job if you don't do this. That's coercion. And if we can't have true informed consent, what do we have? We don't have freedom. And that is why I think it's so important for people to realize this is bigger than this mandate. This is bigger than this shot. There is something that is at play here that I don't know what it is, but it is chipping away at the very foundation of which this country was built
on. And let's again remember, these are three scientists, undercover tape done by Project Veritas, three scientists working for Pfizer, all admitting getting a natural immunity is stronger protection than the vaccine.
Inside portion of the actual virus, so your antibodies are probably better at that point than the vaccination.
Nick Carl is an experienced biochemist at Pfizer with a history of working in the pharmaceutical industry. Nick admits to our undercover journalist that those who've had COVID have stronger immunity than those who've received the Pfizer COVID vaccine.
When somebody is naturally immune, like they got COVID, they probably have better, like not better, but more antibodies against the virus. Because what the vaccine is like I said, that protein that's just on the outside. So it's just one antibody against one specific part of the virus. When you actually get the virus, you're going to start producing antibodies against like multiple pieces of virus. And not only just like the outside portion, like the inside portion, the actual virus. So your antibodies are probably better at that point than the vaccination.
But don't take his word for it. Two other Pfizer scientists echo the same sentiment.
So I mean, well protected?
Yeah.
Like as much as the vaccine?
Probably more.
How so? Like how much more?
You're protected most likely for longer, since it was a natural response.
We're like bred and taught to be like vaccine is safer than actually getting COVID. You cannot like talk about this in public.
If you have antibodies built up, like you should be able to prove that you have those built up.
I mean, I still feel like I work for like an evil corporation. They're trying to keep track of everyone that's been vaccinated versus the census of how many people are actually reported. Basically, our organization is run on COVID money now. You don't talk about anything that can possibly implicate you or like Big Pharma. Like even if you shut the door to the office, it's kind of like, who's listening?
That's stunning. Three scientists at Pfizer all saying immunity, having contracted COVID, is stronger than a vaccine, and also saying that they cannot say it out loud. Stunning. By the way, Joe Biden did it again. He said that Fox News, quote, mandates vaccinations. No, they don't. If you don't get vaccinated, you have to be tested, but they don't mandate vaccinations. He said it before and said it again. B. Kirk up next. I'm